most of the startups or new businesses fail within the first year, and the main reason for that is non-validation of their ideas. Yes, I am going to talk to you about this particular very important thing for a startup. That is, you need to validate your idea before starting a business and not validate after starting. Okay, so let us just jump into this validation thing. In the meantime, my name is Kalyan and I am an online startup coach that you already know, and I have more than 26 years of experience here. So here is the thing. Okay, let us get into that now. Okay, so what is happening is here there are three aspects to validation. Okay, that is to be done before starting your business. So the question number one is, why idea validation? Okay, why should I validate my idea? That is one question which comes. Because you need to confirm whether the idea is great and whether the idea has very good demand. Will there be a good demand for the idea? You may have an excellent idea. For example, if you take the case of Google Glasses, the idea is excellent, and people will say, wow, everything is okay, but it never clicked. It became a failure. Why? Because they could not cater to the real demand of the people. It was not going to be really a demanding thing that people cannot avoid. And the second thing is, you should be targeting the right customers. You have a product, you have a service, you have an idea for a product, and if that product is going to be helpful only to those people who are billionaires or multi-billionaires or something like that, then how many people are going to buy it? So you need to identify the right customers, and that should be serving the purpose of many people who are literally struggling without that. And the third one is, you should have the advantage of this idea, validation, is it reduces the cycle time, the entire cycle time of the process. The iteration cycles are reduced. When you have a very clear idea, when your idea is validated perfectly, you will be saving a lot of time on your product launches and on scaling up. So these are the main thing that why this idea validation is very, very, very important for you. Next we will see, okay, yes, you are told that idea validation is very important. The next question is, how to make that successful? Okay, you have validated your ideas. Okay, then now it is a question of implementing, right? Anyway, you have validated it. Now it is a question of implementing that validation process. Okay, so that will be divided into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 parts. Okay, of that, the most important part is audience taste. Audience taste, in the sense, I mean, the product, some product that you're bringing in, okay, some product which you're bringing to the market should be able to be swallowed by the customer, okay, swallowed by the audience. They should be able to accept, yes, this thing is really cool, okay, I can use it. Okay, so that you should be able to identify the taste of the audience and prepare accordingly. Let me tell you in a very, very simple way, okay. You are living in a place where there is purely only vegetarians, okay, and if you want to try some new, if you want to bring out some new food items which has some content of non-vegetarians, okay, then what will happen? Automatically you are not understanding what is your majority of the population looking for. So first of all, you should be understanding the taste of the audience before making the ideas into implementation. Next is the wavelength, the matching the wavelength, you know. So if you are talking in terms of some rocket science, rocket technology to a common man, he will say, what is this, man? I don't understand anything. Please talk in English, he will say. Am I right? So the wavelength should be matching for you and the guy. Okay, the wavelength should be matching, and the audience should be able to understand that what is the product that you are bringing in there. And the third point, Third, very, very, very important point is, what is so special in your product? Yes. What is so special in your product that will compel a customer to buy it, or that will compel a customer to use it? If there is no speciality, okay, there are so many products available in the market, why should I buy yours? This is the question which will come. So you should be able to identify that one particular USP that is going to make the difference between your competitors. If that is going to make a difference between the competitors, then you can say you are not in the red ocean, you are in the blue ocean, because there is no competition for you, because your idea is working in such a way that nobody else, no other competitor is able to give that. So it is very important to have that so special, something which is so special to the customer that will make him or her definitely buy, ladies and gentlemen. And the next one is how easy it is to use. I know still there are many people who are hesitating to buy an Apple phone because it is not very user friendly. Am I right? You should be accepting that, because I know that I have used both Android as well as an Apple phone. Definitely an Apple phone is not an easy one to start with. You should be struggling a lot, and it is not very, very, very user friendly to the greatest extent. Okay, there are a lot of restrictions, a lot of limitations in that. Okay, still it is a big hit, but the quantum of success, okay, could have been greater if the easiness to use is much, much, much better. They are trying to make everything unique, that is not at all in a user-friendly way, but because of that value form, because of that particular luxury feelings, people are buying it. I am dead sure if you are using an Android phone, if you are using an Apple phone, definitely you will say that, yes, I am very comfortable with the Android phone in usage. Okay, but still I am using Apple phone because of some extra features which is available, because of the extra quality camera that is available, and some of the specific special features. And that is one of the reasons that Apple is not number one, to be honest. Apple is nowhere near other Android phones. Then, the next one is appearance. Okay, you are coming out with a new product or services, and if that is not looking good, if the look is not good, okay, what will happen? Immediately there is a negative feeling coming into the mind of the person. Hey, it looks crappy, why should I buy it? Right? Even if you are talking about services, even if you are talking about the software, if the software, the interface, user interface is not looking good, definitely the customer is not going to buy it. So there is a lot of importance for the appearance factor. So you should be able to evaluate that also. You should be able to validate that also. That is, how good is appearance, how is the feeling of the customer, how the people are giving feedback on the appearance of the product or service. Next is that visual impact. Like, there should be some visual impact. That is, you are saying that I am going to create such a kind of technology products, blah 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 blah, but everything is only through your mouth and nothing is there to show case, then how the customer will respond? Am I right? So you should be in a position to show the customer what is the product going to give, and how the product will look, how it will be physically available, and how it will perform physically. So we should be able to give that visual impact to the customer. Otherwise, you'll be talking about thin air. This is the thing that I'm going to give to you. These are the features that is going to be there. Those are the things that I'm going to remove it. Everything is on thin air. But instead of that, if you could show it to them, that will make a lot of difference. Right? You would have seen that a lot of software companies, what they do is they set up a call with the customer to showcase their new product in such a way that they are not giving any PowerPoint presentation. What they will do is they will give a demo of their product, right? Even if you take the case of car companies, what they do? They don't just tell the customer that this is what is available. Okay, this is all, okay, they will say about the mileage, the warranty and other things. But the business will click only when the company is able to give them a live demo, taking the customer for a drive, making him drive and feel him comfortable. Then the advantage is that the customer will know how the product will look like, how the product will behave, right? So that is, so this is a very, very important. These 6 points are very, very important to be covered before starting your business, before starting your startup or your business. Okay, I'm specifically telling startup and business separately, because definitely startup is not business. Okay, startup is startup and the new business is business. Okay, every new business is not a startup. Okay, but every startup is a new business. Okay, let me make it very clear. And the next point is what are the steps involved in idea validation? So I talked about why is idea validation, then I talked about how to make ideas successful, or how to make the validation process work in a way. And the third one I'm going to talk about is the different steps involved in validation. That is very important, right? That is, everything is the top. If you don't know what are the steps to be maintained, what are the steps to be carried on, then how will you do that? How will you do the validation? Okay, so I'm talking about the steps which are involved in validation. Okay, the first, you should be able to write down what is your goal. I'm not talking about any motivation or something like that here. Okay, you should be able to write down, you should be able to very clearly, you should have a very clear vision of what is it that you want to achieve with this product or service. Yes, where do you want to reach? So it is the most important thing is that you should know where you are heading, and you should also know that who is your target customer. You should also know that where you want to be, and you should also know that where you want to stop or where you want to scale up. And second thing is, if I am drilling down further, if a customer is drilling down further, you should not be fumbling. Okay, so you should be in a position to say, which are the areas? I am talking about validation of your sample, validation of your idea. Idea from sample to T1, then for T2, then for production, then scale up, right? We have different jargons. Okay, I am using these words because it will be easy for everybody to understand. I don't want to say the bootstrapping and all those things, okay? So the second thing is, you should be very clear about what are the assumptions that you are putting into your brain, putting into your ideas, okay? Then, and you have to see if this is my assumption, in actual practice, what is happening? You should be able to have an idea board, validation board, where you can write down, this is assumption and this is actual. Okay, once you are trying to make it live. The second one is, you have to set a standard. Okay, that is up to which point, up to what is the quality standard that you are going to maintain for a product or service. If you are saying that I want to make it 100% perfect, definitely this will become a no beginning product. Okay, it will never begin because you are setting a standard of 100% perfect product only I will come to the market. So you have to set the standard that but this is the point to which I can tolerate. The tolerance level is this. Okay, this is my standard. You should very clearly define, and not only that, you should also tell your people, that is operations people or your marketing people and your purchase people, that this is the standard that I am making out of it. This is the standard that I am looking forward, and we should be able to achieve this and not less, not more. Okay. Then once this is over, that is, you are taking this, you have the idea, then you are what you are doing is, you are making ideas in various ways of doing it, then you are doing various steps, you are using various steps in validation. Then the final thing is, you have done it everything perfectly, the product has come out, it has gone to the market for testing, people have given feedback, okay, and you should be able to decide from there that whether should I, okay, because for customers I got the feedback. For example, the customer has given an excellent feedback. Okay, various customers have given excellent feedback with some corrections. Definitely there will be some corrections to be required. And after doing it, okay, then the product becomes a launchable one. Okay, then you are deciding that you will just go all out into the market with some samples of quantity, then T1 quantity like that. Okay, then what is happening is you should decide whether you should be able to scale up, whether you can scale up directly, okay, whether you can from 1000, you can go straight to 10,000 or 1 lakh pieces or not, or you have to pivot. Okay, and you may be wondering, what is a pivot? Okay, I'll be releasing a separate video on what is a pivot, what's the meaning of pivot in a startup term, in a new business term, because this is one of the term which is very frequently used and is being confused by many people. Okay, so you should be able to scale up, you should be able to decide whether you should be scaling up the product or you should be pivoting it right now. Okay, so in the next video I'll be coming out with what is pivoting and all those things, because my intention is to help startups to know everything and to learn things before starting up, so that 90% of the mistakes are not repeated. 90% of the mistakes are not happening. Because of such mistakes, their business is not failing. Okay, so keep watching my videos and please subscribe to my channel and give your valuable comment and give your valuable questions, send you valuable questions also, so that in future I can come out with the different kinds of videos which will definitely help you people. So I just take this time to thank you so much for being here. Thank you so much for watching my video. Again, I'm saying please subscribe and click the bell icon, and please get in touch with me for any of your startup or requirements, startup strategies or consultations. Okay, my WhatsApp number is given here. Thank you so much and good luck, and see you.